There have been many attempts to design a blood pressure monitor that you can wear on the wrist. And if you look on the web, you can actually see so many smartwatches that claim to monitor blood pressure. The reality is some of them are way off when you compare them or when you take a reading from a proper blood pressure monitor. So they're not even something to be considered. I have heard about the Aktiia 24/7 blood pressure monitor for over a year now. This is a wristband blood pressure monitor which needs syncing with a separate cuffed blood pressure monitor, and then you need to resync it every month. I think the issue I have with the Aktiia blood pressure monitor are quite a few, but I would discuss that later when I probably do a 1 or 2 week review of having used this particular blood pressure monitor. But I have to give it to them. I think it's a positive step towards being able to monitor your blood pressure throughout the day. But I don't think it goes far enough, and I'll discuss that later. So let's see what's in the box. Inside the pack, you have two boxes, one for the wristband and the other one for the cuff. So here's the cuff. The cuff has no display on it, and it syncs with the wristband. Next, you have the wristband. And it comes with a user manual, a USB cable, and a charger. So to start the setup process, you need to download the app from the App Store, be it Android or iOS. Once you've downloaded it, then install. This is the screen you would see once the download is successful. Remove the film from the sensor at the back and get ready to pair the wristband with your app. To pair the wristband with the app, you need to place the wristband on the connected charger. The base of the charger will be flashing in red once the wristband has made connection with the charger. Then we start pairing. The setup instructions are fairly easy and straightforward, so I had no problems with that at all. The first pairing attempt failed, so I'll try again. The system starts to do a firmware update. Firmware update completed. The wristband is now successfully paired with the app. Then you need to pair the wristband with the blood pressure cuff. Start pairing. The wristband is now successfully paired with the blood pressure cuff. Once that is paired, you then put on the wristband. Make sure that it's a snug fit, and then put the cuff on the opposite arm to your wristband. So if the wristband is on the left, the cuff will be on the right. And if the wristband is on the right, the cuff will be on the left. Make sure the cuff has a snug fit around your arm. So here I'm taking my blood pressure reading on my blood pressure monitor. I just want to see how the readings compare. So it did take me about 4 or 5 attempts to be able to get a reading from the Aktiia cuff. I suppose that was because I was doing so many other things at the same time, and it needed me to be still and focused. So after 4 or 5 attempt, I eventually got a reading. reading from my blood pressure monitor and the reading from the Aktiia wristband are not extremely far off, especially when you consider that I was busy filming at the same time. So I think the gap is kind of understandable. One thing I noticed about the app is that you only get blood pressure readings at 2 hour intervals. I think the 2 hour interval is just too large. I would have preferred a 15 minute interval recording of my blood pressure at least. And that's why this device might not be used as an ambulatory blood pressure device. As an ambulatory blood pressure device requires more than just one reading every 2 hours. In fact, it probably might be around 4 readings every hour, which is one every 15 minutes. Because I've used one of these devices before, and the one that I used required a reading once every 10 minutes. So this is where this device actually falls short. And the fact that it actually depends on a cuffed blood pressure monitor says to me that it's using some sort of algorithm to display the readings every 2 hours. And that kind of leaves me a bit less confident about how that algorithm works, and the fact that you have to recalibrate every 30 days is also another issue. But I can say it's on the right path. I am still in search of the perfect wrist-based blood pressure monitor that I can get out of the box and I don't need to calibrate, and that works straight away, and where the reading is not far off from what my cuffed blood pressure monitor would read. So we can put Aktiia in the list of forerunners who are working towards that goal, alongside Huawei, Samsung, YHE Tech, and Omron with their heart guide. This blood pressure monitor costs 200 British pounds or 210 US dollars at the time of this recording. I'll give you a brief update in a few days' time to let you know how I've got on with this wristband blood pressure monitor. If you have any questions regarding this product, please leave it in the comment box below. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care and do everything you can to lower that blood pressure. Bye.